Hello and welcome to Azure Wala YouTube channel. We are in part 109 of Microsoft Certified Associate series. So far we have completed 185 questions in previous videos. Today we are going to look into question number 186. Question 186. Your company has three offices. The offices are located in Miami, Los Angeles, and New York. Each office contains data center. Therefore, we do have three data centers. You have an Azure subscription that contains resources in the East US and West US Azure regions. Each region contains a virtual network. The virtual networks are peered. You need to connect the data centers to the subscription. The solution must minimize network latency between the data centers. What should you create? The keyword in this question is the network latency between the data centers. We have to keep this thing in mind while creating the solution. To understand it better, let's go to learn.microsoft.com. We are on what is Azure Virtual Network page in documentation site. And first we'll learn about virtual network. So let's scroll down. Azure Virtual Network is a service that provides the fundamental building block for your private network in Azure. A virtual network is similar to traditional network that you would operate in your own data center. Communicate between Azure resources. Azure resources communicate securely with each other in one of the following ways. Virtual network, you can virtual network service endpoint, you virtual network peering. You can connect virtual networks to each other by using virtual peering. The resources in either virtual network can then communicate with each other. The virtual networks that you connect can be in the same or different Azure regions. The benefits of using virtual network peering: a low latency, high bandwidth connection between resources in different virtual networks. Gateways and on-premises connectivity. You can also configure the gateway in peered virtual network as a transit point to an on-premise network. Let's understand in the diagram how peering works. So it is displayed here that virtual network B can be peered with virtual network A using a hub virtual network. VNet B is peered with hub virtual network and VNet A is peered with hub virtual network, but these both are not directly peered. And hub virtual network is having VPN gateway with on-premise data center. The resources in virtual network B can use the gateway of hub virtual network and can communicate to on-premises data centers as well as peered virtual networks. Virtual network communication with on-premises resource. You can connect your on-premises computers and networks to virtual network by using any of the following options. The first option is point-to-site virtual private network. Point-to-site virtual private network establishes connection between virtual network and a single computer over the internet. This won't be useful because it is for individual computers over the internet. Site-to-site VPN. It establishes connection between on-premise and Azure virtual network. The third option is Azure ExpressRoute. It establishes connection between the data center and Azure through ExpressRoute partner. Let's understand gateway designs for these connections. We are on VPN gateway design page. First is site-to-site VPN. In this scenario, virtual network connects using VPN gateway and having public IP address over the internet using IPsec tunnel to on-premises data center. You can create more than one VPN connection from your virtual network gateway, typically connecting to multiple on-premises sites. All connections through the gateway share the available bandwidth. This is one of the bottleneck here, that if we do have data center to data center communication, it will be using the shared bandwidth only. So we do have three data center and the communication route would be like this. So from one data center to another data center, it would be communicated through the VPN gateway, and that is the shared bandwidth. So this will be the bottleneck for us. Therefore, we will be discussing about alternate connectivity solution, which is Azure Virtual WAN. Azure Virtual WAN is a networking service that brings many networking, security, and routing functionalities together to provide a single operational interface. And it is used for branch connectivity, site-to-site connectivity, etc. The Virtual WAN architecture is hub and spoke architecture with scale and performance built in four branches. This is what we are looking for. Azure regions serve as hubs that you can choose to connect to. All hubs are connected in full mesh in standard Virtual WAN, making it easy for the user to use the Microsoft backbone for any-to-any connectivity, means branch-to-branch connectivity. Virtual WAN resources. To configure end-to-end Virtual WAN, you create following resources. We have to have Virtual WAN. The Virtual WAN resource represents virtual overlay of your Azure network and is a collection of multiple resources. Hub. A virtual hub is Microsoft managed virtual network. The hub contains various service endpoints to enable connectivity. From your on-premise network, you can connect to a VPN gateway inside the virtual hub. A hub gateway isn't the same as virtual network gateway that you use for ExpressRoute and VPN gateway. Hub virtual network connection. The hub virtual network connection resource is used to connect the hub seamlessly to your virtual network. One virtual network can be connected to only one virtual hub. Next is hub-to-hub connection. Hubs are all connected to each other in virtual WAN. This implies that a branch, user, or VNet connected to the local hub can communicate with another branch or VNet using the full mesh architecture of the connected hubs. You can also connect virtual networks within a hub, transiting through the virtual hub as well as VNet across hub using the hub-to-hub connected framework. Therefore, it is clear that Virtual WAN solution is helpful for us in this case and can be used to ensure branch-to-branch connectivity. Let's understand it better creating a diagram. As given in the question, we do have one Azure cloud. Under the cloud, we do have a virtual network inside East US region and another virtual network in West US region, and these both are peered. Next, we have one data center in Miami, another data center in Los Angeles, and one more data center in New York. Further, we are planning to create a virtual WAN. WAN is like a container for hubs, and virtual WAN is available across the region. Under the virtual WAN, we are going to create a virtual hub that will be connected to Miami data center. Further, we'll create another virtual hub which will be connected to Los Angeles. All the virtual hubs in Virtual WAN are connected to each other. Further, we are going to create another virtual hub which will be connected to these two existing virtual hubs as well as to New York data center, any one of the virtual network above, and this will look like this. Therefore, it will establish the connectivity between all the data centers and virtual networks. Therefore, we will require one virtual WAN and three virtual hubs. Let's go back to question. Therefore, option B, three virtual hubs and one virtual WAN is the correct answer. I hope this video was informative for you. Please hit the like button, subscribe to my channel, press the bell notification icon. Thank you for watching this video. See you in next video.